everyone, I'm JD Hillberry. I wanted to shoot a little video here to show you a progression of this realistic rose drawing and give a short narration of the steps involved with creating it. So stay tuned, that will be coming up in just a minute. This white rose is a subject I recently started teaching in my live drawing workshops. Here's the image on the big screen in class. Remember, this drawing is only 7 inches by 10 inches, so the camera on my drawing board and the large projected image really make it easy to follow along for those in the class. And as you'll see, all the students did very well with the project, even the younger ones. By the way, I give a lot of individual attention in these classes, and they're geared for both beginners and advanced artists. Usually at some point during the workshop, we take a class photo. Just look at all these happy faces. So let's get started on this little time-lapse thing again, and this time I'll go a little slower and include some explanations. It starts off with a white piece of paper and a masking film called frisket. I use frisket when I need to get a clean, sharp edge against a dark background. And if you don't know what frisket is, check out the links in the description here or just Google JD Hillberry frisket and watch that video that comes up. So here, I've cut out the mask of the flower shape and placed it on the white paper exactly where I want the flower to be. Then I use charcoal powder and a soft paper towel to darken the background. This background texture doesn't need to be even at this point, because it's going to change quite a bit through this process. Here I've used a chamois and a kneaded eraser to wipe out and lighten some of that charcoal where I intend to put the leaves to lighten it a bit. Then, using a carbon pencil, I begin to put more detail in the leaves. The carbon pencil looks a little different than charcoal, and that helps make the leaves stand out from the background. In this step, I darkened the background between the leaves with charcoal pencils and added more detail to them with the carbon pencil. Then I sprayed the entire drawing with a fixative to keep the dark charcoal in place. After that, I removed the frisket and began putting in the basic outline of the individual petals of the flower using graphite. I use an F graphite pencil for this outline so it can be easily erased to create soft edges. Now I've started working on the flower petals using a combination of graphite and charcoal. I always start in the darkest areas first so I can use that as a baseline for how dark the other values should be. Here, the center of the rose is the darkest, and it contains the widest range of values. The lighter, softer values are rendered with graphite, and the darker ones are rendered with either charcoal or that special 9XXB graphite pencil that you may have heard me talk about in other videos. In this step, I continue to work on the petals, making sure to compare each petal to its surrounding values. I need to ensure that each one can clearly be distinguished from the one next to it. For many of the lighter values and softer textures, I apply the graphite directly with the stump rather than the pencil. As I work my way down on the flower, I'm careful to clearly identify the cast shadows. I need these cast shadows to look different than the general shading that's on each petal. And they're fairly dark too, so I'll use a combination of the 9XXB graphite and charcoal pencils, which will avoid that graphite shine. These cast shadows help separate the petals as well. See how the petal on the bottom left is starting to pull away from the one next to it? That's the magic of cast shadows. And this is the final drawing. After the last petal was in, I went around and tweaked a few of the values to give a bit more texture and contrast to the flower. And here's an important part I'd like everyone to understand about this particular drawing. There are some relatively dark values in the flower here that make it look so realistic. And the only reason I can put so many darker values in this white rose and still have it look white is because of that dark background. It makes the flower look whiter. In fact, here's that same drawing of the flower against a white background. Notice how it looks like it's now a gray rose instead of white. Since you've made it this far through the video, you must be interested in learning how to draw something like this, and hopefully I've given you an idea of what's involved. Of course, this is only the outline of the basic steps involved. If you really want to take your drawing ability to the next level and learn to create this type of high contrast realism in all of your drawings, you should join me in a workshop for a full 3 days of learning, drawing, and fun. Here's a little bit more about what this class will be like. As usual, everyone will receive reference materials, supplies, and all the personal instruction you'll need to draw the project. part of the tuition, you'll get lifetime access to my membership site and a video tutorial of my light, textures, and contrast workshop. And if you've never taken a workshop from me before, this training includes all the basics of exactly where and how to use all the different pencils, blenders, understanding light and texture, as well as the most important concepts and techniques that I know of to help make your drawings appear to literally pop off the page, no matter what your subject is. Access to this important training will be given in my membership site well before the live workshop begins, so you'll have plenty of time to go through the tutorial. If you've been struggling with trying to get your drawings to look like you know they could, this is the opportunity.